Hey guys, welcome to Couple. Please like and subscribe if you like the video. The act of kindness seemed destined to pull Johnny Bobbitt from the depths of homelessness and drug abuse he struggled with on the day Kate McClure's car sputtered to a stop in front of him. She was a motorist on Interstate 95, a major highway, in Philadelphia who found herself stuck on an off-ramp, scared and out of gas. He was a homeless veteran who told her to lock her doors, then spent his last $20, 15 pounds, on that day in October to bring her a canister of fuel. Read more later. She sought to repay the favor, first with cereal bars and warm socks and spare dollars, then with a GoFundMe campaign to raise money so the Good Samaritan would not have to sleep under a bridge. Mr. Bobbitt, she told anyone who would listen, deserved a fresh start. I wish that I could do more for this selfless man, who went out of his way just to help me that day, she said in the GoFundMe campaign, which she and her boyfriend, Mark D'Amico, crafted in the car after visiting with Mr. Bobbitt. He is such a great guy, and talking to him each time I see him makes me want to help him more and more. They hoped the GoFundMe would raise $10,000, 7,700 pounds, but the story resonated. It was featured in national newspapers, including the Washington Post. The pair made an appearance on Good Morning America and were interviewed by the BBC, a feel-good story at the start of the holiday season. In a few months, the campaign had raised more than $400,000, 300,000 pounds, from nearly 14,000 donors, and Mr. Bobbitt's prospects had brightened. But over the past 10 months, the sweet story has soured. There are accusations of mismanagement and outright theft of the money raised on Mr. Bobbitt's behalf. The GoFundMe cash, Mr. Bobbitt suspected, had been squandered on vacations, a luxury car and more than one addiction. And this weekend, the threat of litigation loomed. Last fall, Ms. McClure said, the plan was to get Mr. Bobbitt a house and his dream truck, a 1999 Ford Ranger. Mr. Bobbitt also planned to donate money to people and organizations that had helped him as he struggled with homelessness. The plan was to make the second act of Mr. Bobbitt's life a successful one, and for a while, things seemed happy. Pictures showed Mr. Bobbitt at Ms. McClure and Mr. D'Amico's house at Christmas, posing next to the tree, wearing adult onesies and baking cookies. In reality, things were not that rosy. Instead of a house, Ms. McClure and Mr. D'Amico got Mr. Bobbitt a camper, which they kept in their names and parked on land owned by Mr. D'Amico's family, according to news reports. They bought him a television, a laptop, and two cell phones, food and clothing, and a used SUV that was soon broken and idle. What he did not get, though, was any type of ownership over the money raised on his behalf. He met briefly with a financial advisor, but there was never any lawyer or any trust, according to television station WTVR. Mr. D'Amico said he kept $200,000, 155,000 pounds, what remained after buying the camper and the SUV and other expenses, in a savings account that he would gladly turn over to Mr. Bobbitt once he kicked an addiction to opioids and managed to hold down a job.